Hey everybody, this is Alex Cequea, editor-in-chief of iPhone Life magazine. I'm sitting here with Adrian Salamunovic, who is the co-founder of canvaspop.com. They specialize on printing on canvas iPhone photography. He's going to tell us all about that and give us some tips on how to make your photography look the best it can on a canvas and print it. How you doing, Adrian?
Doing good, Alex. Thanks.
Thanks for chatting with us.
My pleasure.
So tell me a little bit about Canvas Pop. What do you guys do exactly?
Yeah, well, Canvas Pop is one of the fastest growing canvas printing companies in North America. So a lot of people don't even realize that you can print on canvas. That's all we do. It's the one medium we work with. But what makes us really different is that we're highly focused on iPhonography or mobile photography. It's a good almost half of our business, and it's a fast growing part of our business. We're almost all iPhonographers here ourselves. We love photography. We also love iPhonography. So that's what we do. We specialize in taking almost any image and enlarging it onto canvas.
And what? So you guys have tell me a little bit about Instagram. You guys have a whole special thing around Instagram.
Yeah, I mean, Instagram is one of our first API level integrations that we've done. You know, we're all huge Instagram users here almost from day one. And we saw there's a lot of demand for printing things from Instagram. But we noticed most of the companies were printing, you know, smaller postcard size or smaller items, stickers, magnets, which are all really cool. But we thought to ourselves, well, we've got the technology and the experience to take these small images and enlarge them as big as 20 by 20 inches. So we started experimenting in our photography lab and figured that, you know, we could figure out a way to make these look good. And they do. They look great. It's been our Instagram integration actually been a huge success for us.
Are there any specific challenges in making these photos bigger, in printing them out big?
Yeah, there's definitely challenges, but we're used to them, those challenges, because when we launched nearly, you know, 2.5 years ago, we launched when the only iPhone at that time was the iPhone 3, the 3G, right? And so we were used to working with low-resolution images. We were doing that back then. So there wasn't anything we weren't used to already. And so we took a lot of that expertise and carried it over into the Instagram world. Now, the difference with the Instagram world is you're dealing with lo-fi photography to begin with. That means that the images are allowed to look a little bit grainy. They're allowed to look a little lower resolution. That, combined with our expertise in imaging, combined with the fact that we print on canvas, which is a very forgiving medium, the results are perfect. So these images have been in big shows. They've been in art galleries. They've been in thousands and thousands of homes. And the reviews have been absolutely outstanding. So we're really happy with it.
Did you ever show, like, the Instagram guys this idea? Tell us a story. I know you approached them.
Yeah, well, it wasn't that hard to approach them because we went to a conference. I was telling you earlier, Alex, at a conference called 1197. If you guys want to check it out, it's 1197.is. What it was the first iPhonography conference in the world. It was held in San Francisco, and it was an awesome event. It really felt like all the iPhonography pioneers were there. There's only about 300 people that showed up, so you can imagine what the energy was like. It was an awesome event, and I got to meet Jessica Zollman, who's the community manager, employee number 6 or 7 at Instagram, who was one of the event organizers. And showed her the product, and she really loved it. And got to show it to some pretty famous iPhonographers, and got great feedback from them as well. So it was a great opportunity to showcase the product before we launched it. We got feedback on pricing, and the Instagram folks liked it, so we decided to do an API integration.
Cool. And what about? For somebody like me, right? I'm taking pictures. I want it to look as good as possible, printed like behind me on this blank wall you see here, right?
Sure.
What can I do to make sure that is the best it can be? What kind of things do you see all the time that you wish, oh man, people should, you know, if they were just a little aware of this or a little aware of that, it could be a little bit better.
Well, first of all, I think the cool thing about Instagram is it takes away a lot of that. I mean, almost any picture can look great at least artistically speaking, with Instagram. But there's two things you really can't change. And first and foremost, it's composition, right? If you've got bad composition, your picture's crooked and it's not purposely crooked, or if you're cutting off things, you're not using proper centering or the rule of two-thirds or whatever it is, whatever composition you're trying to get, no artist can fix that after the fact. I mean, that's something you want to watch out for. And then lighting. I think looking for great lighting conditions, whether it's at dawn or in the morning, or, you know, of course not, you know, direct sunlight, or avoiding having, you know, your pictures be too dark. Again, there's limits to what you can do with image manipulation to save a bad image that's not lit up properly. But other than that, honestly, the rule that I think for iPhonographers is have fun with it. Shoot spontaneous moments, you know, just shoot from the hip, so to speak, and enjoy it and just have fun with it and create images that mean a lot to you personally. I think that's the most important thing when you're trying to create a piece of art for your wall, at least.
Yeah. Do you have, can you show us an example? Do you have one handy that you can show us?
We've got a few hundred in the building here, but I just grabbed a couple off my desk because I knew I'd be meeting with you. I mean, you know, what we do here, I mean, we just to show you that you can almost do anything with it, I'll show you a quick example. Every employee in the company has their own portrait made, and we have a wall of fame where, you know, all of our employees are. And this is like one of our great customer service reps that just took a picture. We just took a picture, said, be yourself. And, you know, he's more handsome than I am, so I thought I'd show you that. So every employee has that. That was done on Instagram. No professional photographer, obviously. We just snapshots of our entire staff in front of a brick wall. Looks kind of cool. The next shot is by no means an award winner, okay? This was done, I was doing an interview with CNN about this, and they wanted to see the process, how we shoot. So I just went outside our office and just like took a picture of our door, okay? Now this kind of proved that even a door can look cool on Instagram, but what I wanted to show you is really the quality of it. It's really hard to translate, but it's a low resolution image, but the canvas itself it works with that and kind of allows it to look naturally good. And then, you know, you've got this sort of nice stretcher bars, looks great. It's a 12 by 12. And then the cool thing is, the back of each canvas is hand-signed by the guy that stretched it for you. It's made with love. So that's always kind of a nice thing. They look great. Honestly, I couldn't be more happy with them. I've got about 9 of them in my bedroom, and I'll send you some images that you guys can look at. But I've got a spread of 9 images. I get tons of compliments. You can't go wrong with this stuff. It looks great.
So you're in the building right now where you print all the stuff. Can you give us a little tour? Just a little impromptu tour here.
Sure. I don't think they know this is going to happen, but I don't mind running around. I'm in the second floor of the loft here. So let me. We'll do this GoPro style, I guess, first person, and you can edit out anything proprietary if you see it. You know. So we're going downstairs, and this is the production facility. You can see our values on the wall: be remarkable, be original, be design, and be excellent. That's our shipping department over here. Our DJ table, that's pretty important right now. Our equipment isn't on there, but that's our DJ table that oversees our floor. And then you've got a projection screen. So, you know, when we're having a party, it's important. Let me show you something cool. Right behind me here, you can see, maybe you can see our slogan. Tell me if you can see it. We'll go up here. Up in the rafters, you can see it says, the world is your canvas.
Oh, yeah.
That's kind of cool. That's what we believe. And we've got sort of our lab here and our marketing team. Say hi, guys. iPhone Life.
Hello.
Live. iPhone Life. That's not live. Hi, guys. Sort of have our production department, our sales guy, Kyle. Our cubicles are made of canvas, you know. So it's my business partner, Nazem. Say hi, Naz. It's iPhone Life.
Hey, dude.
Hello. How you doing?
It's actually a live interview with iPhone Life.
Oh, are you serious? Yeah.
It's our development team. And this is the cool part. This is an entire wall made of all of the Instagram pictures that our customers submitted for our contest. So we actually make a wall that features our customers, which is kind of a really cool way to feature, like make our customers part of the story, you know. We've got a design department using using Wacom tablets, Wacom, I should say, all around. We always use, love Wacom, awesome stuff, all Apple. You know, and that's, really, you know, cool. Production facility, everything is, here's some Instagram pictures you can see, bunch of those. See really if someone's cool. Bathroom. Even the bathrooms are creative here, you know, it's all feasy. I don't know if I'm boring you yet, but
so that's, wow, this is awesome.
It's a fairly large building. We're only in part of it, but yeah.
Looks like you got a great workplace there.
It is really fun. The real work happens back here. I mean, most high tech companies don't want to get their hands dirty, right? They outsource production. We actually have people here in North America. We have a Las Vegas facility that's much larger than this. This is our Canadian headquarters. Our Las Vegas facility is about five times the size of this, but we actually even do, there's like a door here, right, with a canvas pop wallpaper on it, then it opens up, and you are like in our actual factory now. This is where the stuff is like hand-stretched, hand-cut. It's, wow. Everything is made right here. Like we make everything by hand. And not a lot of high-tech companies are willing or able to do their own manufacturing. So that's what really makes us really different in this space.
Very cool. So if people want to send you the images, do they go to canvaspop.com through Instagram? Yes. Or do you guys have a specific Instagram portal?
Yeah, we've got the canvaspop.com is the main site. But if they want to do Instagram, they just go to canvaspop.com/Instagram, and they can check it out. Prices start at $39 for 12x12. So there's no reason why you can't get a whole wall done if you want at that price. It's so inexpensive right now. It's about 50% off of retail. So
yeah, that's cool. And they look beautiful. So it's just
they do look great as a whole wall. So for that price, honestly, we wanted to make it pricing that was just like a no-brainer to do, you know?
Yeah, I love it, man. Well, thank you so much for chatting with us and for showing us your awesome company.
It's Alex. Honestly, it was fun. That's a fun interview. I don't usually run around that was cool. That was different.
Yeah, that was definitely fun. And thank you for your tips for our viewers that are watching.
Great. I hope I was. I'm not a professional photographer, but I pretend to be one sometimes. So I enjoy it a lot. Thank you very much. Thanks for your time, Alex.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Adrian. Okay. Take care.